the authorizations that were used for Afghanistan was in direct response to the attack on our country. The authorization for use of force in Iraq that I opposed was aimed at one specific circumstance. I think it's critically important that Congress update the authorization for the use of force. So I think it's important that we alter the 2001 and 2002 authorizations, and I hope that we will do that to meet the current needs. The current needs we understand on ISIL. I have very strong concerns about going into a country where we don't have consent, Syria. In Iraq, it's a little bit easier because the country wants us there. So I think we need to modernize the authorizations, and Congress should do that. I think one of the lessons learned from Iraq is that just because we use American ground troops does not mean we'll be successful in a mission. I don't think we want to see a long-term U.S. commitment in regards to being in another country where a lot of the problems are internal and need to be dealt with by the country itself. So no, I don't believe we should be using extensive military operations in these countries, and I certainly don't believe we should commit to a ground war. Russia's paid a very heavy price for their aggression. The sanctions that not only the U.S. has imposed, but also Europe, has had a major impact on the Russian economy. The cost of maintaining Crimea has a major cost on the Russian government. So yes, I do think the international strategies have worked. We've made it clear that Russia's going to pay a price for their aggression in Crimea and also in eastern Ukraine on the border issues. So I think that the strategy is working. We knew it would not be a short-term success, that it would take some time. And I do think that we now need to look at how we can strengthen Ukraine and the institutions within Ukraine so that it can have a government that truly represents all the people of their country. We didn't go to Afghanistan by choice. We went there because there was an attack on our country and that the center of that attack was in Afghanistan. That's the reason why we went to Afghanistan. We got distracted by Iraq. I don't believe we ever should have used our military in Iraq. I think we should have completed Afghanistan well before we did. We were distracted, and as a result, Afghanistan became more of a challenge than I think we thought originally. And yes, I think the objectives we had was to root out the terrorist organizations that were responsible for the attack on our country on September the 11th. I think we've done that effectively in Afghanistan. Are there still problems in Afghanistan? You bet there are. But they're not of the making that would require a U.S. military presence. The Afghan government really needs to deal with corruption. It's a huge problem. It's not one person. It's not one government. It's been there for a long period of time. They need to deal with a sustainable economy, get off of the drug trades and deal with sustainable economic activities within their country. They need to deal with the tribal realities of the country. So they have a lot of challenges, but it starts with a representative government, a government that roots out corruption and represents all the people of Afghanistan. Israel has no greater friend than the United States. That strength is in both the administration and in the Congress. It's Democrats, it's Republicans. I just got back from 2 days in New York, talked to the Israeli mission. There is no country like the United States that uses its leadership, the United Nations, to protect our friend Israel from the unjust attacks. That relationship is as strong as ever. The United States has taken a very strong position in regards to so many issues that are important to Israel. I don't see anything that has weakened that stance between our two countries.